You're watching a video series on schema stitching, and in this example we're going to be talking about type merging, and specifically type merging using single record queries. Single record queries being queries that will go and fetch a single record at a time. This is not the most efficient way to go and merge result sets together into one output, but it's a good example and shows how batching works very nicely. All this code is available in the Schema Stitching Handbook repo. So to do a quick run through of the code here, what we have are three services. First, we've got the manufacturer service. It has a very simple schema with one type in it and some data fixtures that are being resolved. Then there's the product service. A product has a manufacturer. And then we've got the storefront service. And storefronts have products. Lastly, we've got our stitched gateway code, which we'll walk through later. Schema stitching uses a system where types are merged together from across services. So in this first column, we have the gateway schema, and that is an aggregate of these three subservices. So here we've got the types that are in the manufacturer service, which is just this one with a name. We've got all the types that came from the product service, and you'll see that manufacturers has crossed over between products and manufacturer services. And so if we look in the gateway, there's a name field that came from the manufacturer service. There's a products field that came from the product service. And the gateway knows that these are the same type because they share the same name. And then they are brought together as one object in the gateway proxy layer. And then likewise, the same thing happens over here with the storefront service. Storefront has an ID, a name, has an array of products. And products in this case, the local representation is just this UPC, which crosses over with the UPC in the product service. And in the truest sense, what this type here is in the storefront service, this is a foreign key. It has a type and it has a key that points to a record in a different location. And so this tiny foreign key pattern is actually extremely common in schema stitching. In this case, we would say that the storefront service has no unique data for the product because over here, there are unique fields. These three are not available anywhere else. This UPC field is available in two services. So storefronts has no unique data to offer product. It simply is a reference to another location. So we would consider this a one-way merge. We're only ever going to be taking products from the product service and putting them into storefronts data. We'll never be taking data from storefronts and putting it into products. And then over here for manufacturers, you can see that we've got a unique name in the manufacturer service and a unique products in the product service. So we would call this a two-way merge, as in a record could originate for a manufacturer in this service and have only a name and it will need to get a product, or a record could originate with only products in this service and it will need to go out and get a name. So this is a multi-directional merge. All right, if we want to see our services running together, let's first start all of our subservices. And then in a new terminal window, let's start our gateway. All right, our gateway is running. Let's go over here. And we have a query here that's going to go and hit a storefront and bring in data from across services. So if we actually look at where all of this data comes from and start breaking this down, we're starting out hitting the storefront service, and storefronts is going to provide these fields here. That gets us to that product's foreign key, which goes and joins over into the product service. Inside the product service, we're going to be getting these fields here, which are unique to the product itself. And then that joins to that foreign key over to manufacturers, the foreign manufacturers type. And that manufacturer is then composed of one field that we got from the manufacturer service itself, and then one manufacturer field referencing products, which came from the product service. So actually breaking this down, this merged set of data came from all three services in four different sets. So we had our storefront set, our initial generation of products data, then our manufacturer's set of data, and then a second generation of products data. Switching over to our gateway stitching code, first we've got our three remote executors set up to talk to each of these subservices. We provide the remote schema and executor as described in the combining local and remote schemas video. And then this batch and merge setting are two new ones that we're talking about here. And we're going to start with this merge setting. It's the thing that says how types merge between subservices. And we're going to start by talking about the product service and the storefront service. Since they do the one-way merge, you can see there's actually no merge config on storefronts itself. So this is a pretty simple one. So we're going to go and look at the storefronts schema and the product schema. Bring those side by side. So storefronts has this product type, which is effectively a foreign key. It's got a UPC field that matches the UPC field on the product service. And so basically what we want to do is whenever a storefront originates a product object, it's going to have nothing but a UPC, which is the foreign key available here. We want to go and take this kind of, if you want to say, a seed. It's the original object that is representing what we want to build into a fully formed product. We're going to take the UPC field from that and then send it over to the product schema. And you can see we've actually got a query here that would be able to receive that. So we've got a query for a product. It receives a UPC and it returns the version of product that is available in the product service. So by using this, we could basically start here with a foreign key that's originated inside of the storefront service, read the UPC off of it, send that UPC over to this query as the argument, get back one of these fully formed product types, and then we could take the results of the original representation and this queried product type, put those together, and that would give us a fully formed product. So that's exactly what we do here in configuration. So you can see in the product schema, we've configured, all right, for merge, I want to merge the product type. And whenever I'm going to merge the product type, the field that is needed to perform a query for this this GraphQL type is going to be UPC. Basically, think of the selection set as being what we need for an argument. So in this case, we're going to use this query, we need this argument, and we're going to produce this object. So this is the object, this is the argument that we're going to need to pull from another service. This is the field, the query name, that we're going to talk to. And then this is where we actually build the arguments that we go and we send over. So we're going to go and pluck the UPC off of the original representation that came from here, this little foreign key. So we'll pluck the UPC off of that, and then we'll format it into an object. This is effectively saying UPC argument is UPC field. And then this constitutes a query that we're going to make. So we're going to query the product field, giving it a UPC argument, and that is the UPC value read off of the original representation that we had. And so these two together give us our one-way merge. Now, the exact same thing happens with multi-directional merges. So in this case, we might have a manufacturer originate in the manufacturer's service and include a name, or it might originate in the product service and include products. In either case, this manufacturer needs to be able to access a name, and this manufacturer needs to be able to access products. So we need queries in the opposing services so that either representation will be able to access the other service to get the missing data that it needs. So we've got, again, a merge query set up here that takes an ID, returns a manufacturer. Same query, takes an ID, returns a manufacturer. And then down here inside of our merge configuration, we've again set up merges for the manufacturer type in both of these services. We've got a selection set specified saying that in either case, we'll need to collect an ID from the original representation. Then we'll send it to one of these two fields. And then we'll build an ID argument sent to that service. Now, concerning naming here, we've got manufacturer and we've got underscore manufacturer. And this is done simply because we only want one of these to be available as a public name. So it doesn't really matter to the gateway what service names are called. However, to humans using this gateway, they would want to go and talk to something that's logically named manufacturer. This query here is going to be more of a machine-only service that's available to our Stitch gateway for getting this type. And therefore, we just kind of underscore it, and then we could go and write a filter to go and remove any fields prefixed with an underscore from our final gateway schema. Now, I said earlier that this wasn't the most optimal version of doing type merging because we're using single record queries, and meaning this query that we're using takes a single argument and returns a single result. And so the implication of that is whenever we perform merging using a single record query, we're going to be doing a subservice delegation, a subservice request every single time that we encounter a record. And so let's actually look at the implications of that. So I've got this query here that's set up. We're going to talk to the storefront. We're going to look at the products that it has. And if I make this request, you can see over here in console, I've set up logging on the actual executions that we're doing. Each of these executions actually represents a remote network request and then a operation performed by the subservice. So in this case, the storefront service had three little product keys that it originated. So it had three representations of a product that all needed to go and have data brought in to flesh them out. And in this case, we're using these single record queries. So it took each UPC that was provided by the storefront service and then came over here and it performed a separate both network operation and then subservice query to go and get each one of those results. So this is by definition what we'd call an N plus one query. We can make this a lot better. GraphQL Tools has execution batching, which is built natively into schema stitching. So if we just enable batch true, save that. My gateway restarted, and now let's run this query again. And you can see this new query that I just ran looks a little bit different. In this case here, what's happened is Schema Stitching has talked to the batch execution package and actually taken what used to be three separate operations and consolidated them into one operation. This represents one network request sent to the subservice and one operation that is actually executed. Therefore, more database batching might actually be able to be consolidated when we're running this one operation versus if we were to send three separate operations and have to go and hit the database three different times for each of those. So there's a lot of advantage in just using the out-of-the-box query batching. That said, this alone is not a perfect solution. This makes it a lot better, but you need to also think about the fact that the gateway has to go and process each time we go and we reach out to go and fulfill a record. The gateway needs to do a certain level of processing on every single record that we get. And in this case, we're still going and making single record queries, so single delegations to an underlying service. And each of those three delegations has to be processed. We're basically doing the same work three times in a row and then consolidating that into one network request. The network request got a lot more efficient, but the gateway layer is still doing more work than it needs to. So in the next installment, we'll be looking at array batching, which would go and allow these three delegations to be consolidated into one request for an array of records. Thank you for watching. All of this code is available in the Schema Stitching Handbook repo. I will include a link to it with the video. Until next time, thank you.